Here's your check for the Animaniacs reboot, you sellouts.
So, a little late, but I wanted to make a pit stop on Merch Week to share my thoughts on Animaniacs, finally releasing a trailer, making the official stamp of coming back. So back in 2018, Hulu announced the reboot of the early 90s animated series. We know now that in addition to the series being set to premiere November 20th, 2020, that a second season will come out the year after. Full disclosure, as much as I know about the show and really love the Pinky and the Brain parts, I didn't really grow up with it. By the time I was born, it was pretty close to wrapping up, and Kids WB wasn't the highest priority at the time for anything other than Johnny Test and Static Shock. With that being said, Animaniacs is one of those shows that I'd have a hard time finding someone else who doesn't like it. A lot of people enjoy the humor, enjoy the shelf life, the art style, and the music. For a show that people resonate both then and now, you would expect for the reboot to have high expectations set to it, and it did. We'd get a sneak peek with the trailer released October 21st, and speaking of, just to get this out of the way, they released another sneak peek titled Animaniacs Jurassic Park Clip, and that was 2 weeks ago from the time of writing this, yet it has fewer views than a trailer that came out 5 days ago. In addition to that, the trailer itself has its likes to dislikes disabled, yet the clip from 2 weeks ago doesn't. And that has an incredible ratio, and it seems like a lot of people did enjoy it. I'm sure there's standards and practices, or a corporate reason, or just some out-of-touch reason why this was done, but just as a person, a part of the YouTube culture, turning off the likes and dislikes just sets off a red flag for me. Luckily, this was a false positive because the trailer was great.
All right, guys, there's a lot of pressure on our first lines. Wait, don't. Make sure it's good first. Maybe something reminiscent of the first season?
The show seems to be as sharp as it was before, and people really love it. The biggest hurdle of a reboot is its first impression, especially from older fans. A lot of people enjoyed a bouncy animation, getting the original voice actors, and not being afraid to get meta, however, not to the detriment of fans. I'm not going to get on the bandwagon of calling this the best reboot of the 21st century, or even the best reboot since Teen Titans Go, but so far, this seems to be one of the rare reboots ever since I started doing YouTube that seems to be faithful towards the original, but also loved by fans, and have seemed to adjust quite well to this new time. I'm getting the same vibes here that I also did with Enter the Florpus and Set It Cling, two specials that seem to do very well with the original fanbase. However, pulling back the curtain here, we have to remember that reboots are made to attract new fans to the franchise. So as much as old fans may enjoy it, they need new fans to keep it going. I believe that this reboot strikes that balance in having older fans appreciate a lot of the subtle things about the show, while not alienating a new audience that feels like they need to binge 99 episodes and a feature-length film in order to begin understanding all of the characters. Speaking more about that second clip, the Jurassic Park clip, it was incredibly funny. It felt like a proper parody, and it had this interesting line within it.
Clean vectored outlines, wide screen format.
These don't look like reruns.
They're not. I reanimated them.
It's not a reboot, but a reanimation, which seems to resonate with a lot of different people when it comes to seeing just under 2 minutes of this upcoming show. So it's clear to everyone that I obviously like this, I want to see this, and I most likely will cover it. However, let's talk about something that interests me, the visual development of this show. Initially, the idea of exploring other art styles, it was on the table, and it led to a lot of different and interesting styles. So as you see here, I particularly want to highlight the photorealistic one, even though I think the two on the right aren't that bad due to the drawn on eyes, people would have lost their minds if this was the style that they stuck to. Like, if they had the same character design philosophy as Pickle and Peanut, there'd be a lot of angry videos out now, even though the style really isn't that bad by itself, just because that specific style, the photorealistic one, would be attached to a series like this, I feel like a lot of people wouldn't think that that would mix and be okay. However, they did decide to stick with the original designs. However, it's interesting that within the trailer, we do see a lot of other designs, and they do look very nice. They look sharp, they look clean, they don't look like the people who are drawing them didn't take into consideration the style of the show, the philosophy of it, and just how the characters would be, their personality, you know, just things like that that would make it seem like the designs and the redesigns within the trailer would look out of place. They studied the OG show, seeing that there really wasn't a single look because the show was passed around through a lot of animation service studios. So after a lot of refinement and looking through all of the different different choices. It seems as though even though they've adapted to this widescreen format and newer software, they look as great as they've done before. Honestly, it took me seeing the new and old design side by side for me to notice the very tiny and subtle differences between them. However, I don't think that those subtle differences would be game-changing to anyone. In fact, I would believe, just like how this article says, that they designed it in the way that people remember them as, rather than how people thought them to be. Because these new designs look a lot more cartoony and wacky, however, I love them all the same. They've gotten it down to traits such as angular expression, simplified detail, asymmetry, everything else you see on the screen here. Unlike many rollouts of reboots, the behind the scenes look here really nails the point home that we can confirm through the details shown to us that they've not only watched the original show, but went out of their way to understand the culture and philosophy of the show from design to humor.
I've tried online dating, but I keep getting catfished. How do I know she's even real?
And it's with that you look at other shows, other reboots like the Powerpuff Girls reboot, where it doesn't appear that the people behind it really understood what the original show was going after, and it makes you feel like this show has a lot going for it. In fact, this kind of reminds me of Close Enough, even though that's not necessarily a reboot, but it keeps a certain style, an atmosphere, a certain philosophy of the writing from a show that's very, very similar to it via the creator, and it really retains that sort of feel and enjoyment that you would get from both shows, thus not alienating anyone who watched the OG regular show to feel like Close Enough wouldn't be for them. Although it is a little bit more raunchy, it sort of retains that same feel, and I feel like this Animaniacs reboot very well may do that. In fact, it would be disappointing if they didn't do that. Honestly, there's a lot more to the behind the scenes nature of it, but I didn't want to rip off the whole article, to be honest with you, so I'm gonna put it in the description below if you'd like to read it. Feel free to. You've probably already seen a lot of videos on this. This is just a very short video I wanted to put out in the middle of merch week. I just picked the part that was most interesting to me in the article, but there's a lot of cool stuff in it. But anyway, let me know what you think of the Animaniacs reboot. I'm pretty sure that is the only reason I'm going to be getting Hulu. Drop everything down in the comments below. I love reading them all. Until next time, guys, thank you so much for your time. Take care. Alpha out.